So, have a seat. I know you guys are kind of tired. Okay. So, first try, let's just do some practice in conducting, okay? Why don't you guys just do the conducting in both hands? Okay? Simple? Okay. So, one measure after me, and you're gonna do only conducting and listen for the patterns or any rhythms that are lined up, okay? Any question? Okay, so here we go.
Was it confusing because the pattern didn't have the last quarter note? Mm-hmm. It's a consistent beat, right? So you mean I want you to do the conducting in one hand, okay? Which hand you prefer? Okay. So just do the conducting in one hand, and I want you to try tapping the rhythms on your knee. Okay? Alright? Everybody clear?
In canon?
Yes.
Obviously.
Yeah, obviously. Okay. So one hand conducting, keep the conducting, and the other hand tapping the rhythms, okay? Alright. So let's try that. one where we did only the conducting. So how was it, Maggie? Mm-hmm. How was it for you when you? So we did conducting first, mm-hmm. and just now we did conducting and tapping the rhythms, right? Mm-hmm. So using the different hands, but you're basically doing the two different things at the same time, right?
Yeah.
So how was it?
I think it was helpful to do the conducting before that,
yeah.
and then the transition
okay.
to having it in one hand and then tapping it.
Okay. So when we did the conducting first, you actually got a chance to listen for how the rhythms line up with the beat, right?
Yeah, I think it helped with the offbeats especially.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
usually I struggle with those.
Yeah, and all the other patterns, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, Molly, how was the conducting this time? And how was the special pattern for the offbeat kind of sweeping four thing with that recorder?
I think it's just something I should practice.
Yeah. So when you practice, when you guys practice, don't just go into the fast tempo and panic, okay? So just get your paper, like the vocab sheet you have, and do the conducting first. And I mean, not just conducting, but when you do conducting, and listen for the rhythms and how they line up, okay? And that will help you. I mean, I actually practiced like that. So when I was in this class, like 2 years ago. Anyways, so now I want you to stand up. Sorry, you guys are tired. Sorry. Okay, so now keep the conducting in both hands and step the rhythms, okay? Right? So now let's try that. Oh, you're just gonna stand, okay? Not in a circle yet. You're doing two different things at once, right? One hand. But when you're stepping the rhythms, you're doing two different things in a different manner, right? So was it confusing? No, right? How was the three against four pattern, like an offbeat?
Three against four?
Three against four without that plus one.
Four against three.
Four against three, whatever. Yeah. Okay, how was the pattern? Sorry. Okay, so is it hard without looking at the sheet, like organizing the rhythms?
Yeah.
when you step, especially the last beat, you guys have some kind of off beats, right?
I think what makes it hard, but you just have to live with it, is that both you and Mr. Swagger, when you play that, you go da 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 bum bum.
Yeah,
da,
I was okay.
Usually
was
the bass happens in the downbeats.
Yeah, yeah. So there, okay, I'm sorry if I confuse you guys, but that was kind of my intention to help you to realize the downbeat.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so because sometimes when I just do. Sometimes when I hear the downbeats, it kind of helps me to reorganize the structure a little bit. So, you want it. Did you like the process? How was it for you?
I think it's getting better.
Getting better?
Yeah.
So did you like the previous process or tapping or stepping?
I like stepping.
Stepping better. Okay. Yeah. Alright. So, guys, now let's try the real canon, okay? Walk in a circle. And keep the conducting going, and let's try it for real, okay? Remember the patterns and listen for the double caps. Okay, here we go. Cross rhythms, you mean this? So why don't we try that, just stepping and conducting in a slower tempo, okay? Got it? Okay, so let's try that. Once more.
use Hado in it.
Yeah.
I think it helped me.
Okay.
Because I think Mr. Swigert mentioned this before, but I wasn't really thinking about it until now. That you step the steps align with one, then four, then two, then three.
Yes. 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 And I don't know if this might help you, but when I practiced, while I was preparing for this, do you see that? Oh, do you see the very first beat of each measure? So that's the first measure. I mean, first beat of first measure. The second, first beat of second. So thank you. It's I mean, we play this for beat, right? Upbeat. And the first beat of the last measure, third measure is. So we play, right? So do you see the pattern? The first beat, each measure. So we have. I don't know if you guys, if this is the same for me or not, but when I practice this for this, I realize the pattern here. And when you guys think about this as a whole bunch of chunk of pattern, it will kind of confuse you and like, where am I, right? But when you think about the first beat, when you get lost, you can think, oh, this is the second beat of the pattern, okay?
So if I can piggyback on this, when I was just doing it, I don't get to do canons as often as I get to play them, so it's fun for me to actually get to do it. It's fun! Canons are fun!
Yay!
I was watching how, again, on the first beat, how the first articulation bounced off the conducting. And my big checkpoint was, am I doing this correct? Is when I was here and I stepped, mba!
Yeah.
And as soon as I felt that mba, I knew I was home free. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, Molly noticed that. That lines up on 3, and then 2. Okay, 1, 4, 3, 2.
Yeah.
Articulations on the first beat. It's the same thing.
So before you finish, I'm sorry to interrupt. Before you finish, just like.
Yep.
So, I just want to give you a tip for practicing that certain pattern because, I mean, when you practice or vice versa, it's kind of, I won't say it's simple, but it's fairly easier than this pattern because you have downbeat at the end, right? Or the first beat. But when you have this, it's like really like a, you know, like a maze. So, when you practice, I want you to think about practicing the conducting first, okay? So, and think about the rhythms. That's why I gave it downbeat. Okay? Was it better? Clear, right? Yeah, so conducting first, when you practice, not just for canon, it's just for practice. When you practice 16 also, do the conducting straight out first and listen for how the vocab rhythms are lined up. And that will help you in actual performance exam, okay? Any questions? Was it fun? I like canons. Was it fun?
All right, Suchi, thanks.
Yeah.